I am Dr. Muhammad Shoaib and our today's lecture is Paternò-Bucci reaction, which is also called as photocycloaddition reaction. It is very easy and important topic, so let's start. One of the first studied photocycloaddition reaction was the formation of oxytane from addition of carbonyl compounds to alkene. This reaction is known as Paternò-Bucci reaction. Here is the reaction of benzophenone with isobutane, which produces oxytane in a high yield. This reaction can be studied under two categories, which depends upon the nature of alkene. First one is the addition of electron-rich alkene. Mechanism shows that reaction pathway varies according to the type of carbonyl compound and alkene. Addition of aliphatic or aromatic ketones to electron-rich alkene, as shown here, involves attack on ground state alkene by N to pi star triplet state of the carbonyl compound in a non-concerted manner, giving rise to all the possible isomers of oxytane. Here are the two possible isomers of oxytane which are produced. Here is the ketone in its triplet state. First of all, here it is the aromatic ketone. In the presence of light, it is excited to the S1. Then after intersystem crossing, it is converted into triplet state. Here is the triplet state. The biradical shows that the reaction will not be concerted. First of all, this one electron will react with one electron having opposite pair spin to this double bonded carbon. Here are the two possible intermediates, and in both intermediates 1,4 biradical are there. These must undergo spin inversion to complete the product formation. Here the upper portion in both these intermediates is same, but this free radical is more stable than this one. Remember that free radicals are electron deficient in the case of carbon, and the more electron donating group stabilizes the free radical. Here are the more electron donating methyl groups as compared to hydrogen here, so it is more stable free radical. Spin inversion takes place by the rotation of the single bond, and the bond formation results in the 90% yield of this isomer and 10% yield of this isomer. Due to the two isomers, the reaction is not stereospecific, and the preference of one orientation can be rationalized in terms of initial attack to alkene by the oxygen at the excited carbonyl group to give a biradical intermediate. The more energetically stable of the two possible radical is formed more readily, that is this one. Thus the reaction is regioselective reaction. Biradical stability is certainly applicable to the prediction of major product in cycloaddition reaction. So there are two important rules of successful synthesis of oxytane. First is that only carbonyl compound with a low lying N to pi star state will form oxytane. And second rule is that the energy of carbonyl excited state must be less than that of the alkene to prevent energy transfer from the carbonyl excited state to the alkene. As far as the addition of aromatic carbonyl compound is concerned, as we have seen, only the triplet state is reactive, and consequently a triplet biradical intermediate is produced. and the reaction of alkyl ketones can be complicated by the less efficiency of inter-system crossing, thus permitting the reaction of both the singlet and the triplet state. Both singlet and triplet shows the same reactivity with alkyl ketones. However, the singlet state reaction is obtained by the high concentration of alkene. If we have high concentration of this alkene, then this alkyl ketone behaves as a singlet and only one product is formed, which is a major product. On the other hand, if alkene are low in concentration, then the alkyl ketones are triplet, and similar to the aromatic ketones, two products are obtained. Next is the addition of electron deficient alkenes. Photocycloaddition of aliphatic ketones to electron deficient alkenes, particularly diisoethene, involves addition of singlet state N2 pi star excited ketones to ground state ketone. The reaction is stereospecific and the stereochemistry of alkene is retained. As this ketone behaves as a singlet, so there is no biradical formation and there is no rotation of bond for the intermediate. So the cis alkene produces cis product and the trans alkene produces trans product. Here is a very interesting situation. In photocycloaddition of electron deficient alkenes to the ketone, oxetanes are formed only from singlet state, as we have seen in the previous reaction. But if we have ketones in the triplet state, there is no product formation. This triplet state ketone only sensitizes the cis transformation of this alkene. It behaves as a photosensitizer and transfer its energy to the alkene. The cis is converted into trans and the trans is converted into cis, while the ketone remain as such. So there is no oxetane formation, but there is only conversion of cis alkene to trans and vice versa. In case of unsymmetrical alkenes, formation of an exiplus between carbonyl excited state and a olefin ground state plays an important role. Here is an exiplex between a carbonyl and an alkene. Suppose an electron is transferred from this carbon to this oxygen, and this oxygen gets negative charge and the carbon gets positive charge. So there is only one possibility that this oxygen will form bond with this carbon. The exiplex has considerably charge transfer and a stereospecific formation of the product is accounted for if both new bonds are formed simultaneously in the exiplex, that is concerted one, or if the second is formed after the first at a rate faster than the rate of bond rotation. There is again a preference for one orientation of addition, as we can see here, but opposite to that expected on the basis of more stable biradical intermediate. Here no biradical intermediate is formed, so the only preference is the formation of positive and negative in exiplex. The preference of the preferred orientation in the exiplex is governed by the charge densities as stated below. Here is a carbonyl, oxygen is partial negative, here it is the alkene, and this carbon is partial positive due to the strong electron withdrawing cyano group. So there is only one possibility that this partial negative will react to form bond with this partial positive and this exiplex is formed, which is converted into the final product. So there is only one orientation. it is not possible that this partial negative oxygen will react with this partial negative carbon to form other isomer of this oxytane. Next is the oxytane formation with dienes. Addition of carbonyl compounds to conjugated diene is also feasible. The energy of triplet state of diene is usually less than that of carbonyl compounds. However, the formation of oxytane competes successfully with excitation energy transfer because diene quenches to the triplet state. Thus, formation of oxytane occurs from the singlet state of carbonyl compound. Therefore, in singlet state, the product is always stereospecific, whether these are alkene or dienes. Here is a carbonyl. Oxygen has partial negative. So in hexaplex formation, this oxygen will form bond with this carbon. As the negative charge on this carbon is more stable due to the resonance, so this carbon will have partial positive charge and this carbon will have partial negative charge. Oxygen will form bond with this carbon, which is partial positive. As in the case here, there are two products, but there is only difference between the hydrogen which are present and at the bridged carbon, and there is no formation of other possible isomer. Here is another example. When ketone reacts with 1,3-butadiene, there are two possible isomers formed. When we will see the mechanism, here it is a singlet state. The one electron from this double bond will form bond with one electron from oxygen, and the 1,4 biradical intermediate is obtained. There are two possibilities. Either oxygen can form with this CH carbon or CH2 carbon, as in the second case. In both cases, 1,4 biradicals are produced. As I have mentioned earlier, that the free radicals are electron deficient, so this free radical will be more stable as compared to the free radical on primary carbon. Therefore, this product will be minor product and this product will be a major product. Of course, this bond formation and the cyclic oxytane formation will take place only when this bond rotation takes place between these two electrons. Next is the oxytane formation with alkynes. Carbonyl compounds undergo photochemical cycloaddition reactions to alkyne to give oxytane, which are usually not isolated but isomerizes to alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compounds upon thermal reaction. Here is an alkyne and here is a carbonyl compound. It forms this oxytane, and when it is heated, a rearrangement of bonds takes place to produce alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compound. Here is another example. The product is same alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compound. After intramolecular Paternovici reaction, intramolecular Paternovici reaction is also possible. It is mainly given by gamma eta enones, as it is carbonyl carbon. It is alpha, this is beta, this is gamma, and this is eta carbon. The efficiency is attributed to the rapid rate of interaction between the excited carbonyl group and the ground state carbon-carbon double bond, as we have seen previously. This combination of substrate allows the formation of only one isomer in high yield, and usually there is no byproduct. Reaction is highly versatile for the synthesis of variety of bicyclic compounds. Here is an enone. When we redry it, this oxygen will form a bond with this carbon, and this free radical will be produced, which is more stable, and the bond formation between these two electrons takes place and the final product is obtained. Here is another example. The mechanism is same for all these examples. And one of the most important reaction of this class is the preparation of azoline as follows. It is 2-allyl cyclohexane 1 known. This carbonyl is shown in the form of free radical. First, this oxygen will form a bond with this carbon to produce a 5-member ring. And then this carbon and this carbon will form another 5-member ring. And here is a difference between the reaction mechanism or path or the formation of free radical from the previous one. Here we expect that this oxygen will form a bond with this carbon to produce its free radical on this secondary carbon atom, which is more stable, as we have seen in all the previous example. But this does not take place, and this free radical, which is less stable, it is formed. The reason is that if this oxygen will form a bond with this carbon, then a 6-member ring will be formed. And when this carbon will form a bond with this carbon, a 4-member ring will be formed. Thus, one cyclic structure will be 6-membered, another will be 4-membered. But in this case, the two cyclic structures obtained, both are 5-membered, which are more stable as compared to the 6 and 4-member ring. So the ultimate product formation governs that which free radical is formed. And that's all about Paternò-Bucci reaction. If you have any question, don't hesitate to ask me. Thank you.